Hi, I'm Steve Garrett, and I'd like to talk to you a little bit about the budgeting part of financial stewardship. First of all, budgeting is policy. It is the ultimate policy that governs a Rotary Club. And because it's policy, it's a responsibility of the board of directors, the treasurer, the president, but it's a responsibility of the board of directors to pass a budget, because it is policy. The primary thing about a policy as budget is that it is the authorizations. When we say this is the budget, you're authorizing a committee chairman, somebody else to do something, and you're authorizing the amount of money that they can spend to do that. But it's also a delineation of the limitations. When you say it's a limitation, it doesn't mean that it can't be adjusted or changed in expenditures. It doesn't say that it can't be adjusted or changed in revenue, but it is the limitation, and it's the limitation designated by the board of directors. So how do you do a budget? Well, you know, when I talk about reading financial statements, I say start with the notes. So same thing, when you're going to make a budget, start with the notes. The notes in the case of a budget are, what are the assumptions? How many members do you have? What are the dues? How much is it going to cost to do something? What's the source of, just write that all down so that when somebody else looks at the budget, they can see what your assumptions were in creating the budget. And remember, a Rotary Club is really two separate organizations if you do it right. There's an inward-looking 501c4, and there's an outward-looking 501c3. And there's differences, and there's a video about what the differences are. But those differences mean that you really should have two budgets, one for the inward-looking budget operations, one for the outward-looking charitable expenses. So make two budgets. When you go to make the budget, one of the important things to do is don't just make it, they call it zero-based budgeting. Don't just start from scratch. Start from the last year's budget, the year before's budget. How much was budgeted? How much was expended? Did they over-budget? Did they under-budget? And it gives you some guidelines for creating your budget for the year that's going on. And don't forget, create a rainy day fund. I have long been an advocate that you raise money and you put some aside. And if you put enough aside over a period of times, eventually you can get to the point that the money that you raise this year becomes the money that you spend next year. And that's really important for budgeting, because now when you know that your fundraising raised so many dollars last year, you know what your budget to expend this year is. And it gives you a much better basis for budgeting. And don't overlook past experience. If you don't do after action reports for all of the activities, how do you know whether the activities that you did were successful, that the budgets were successful, and that you guessed right on your budgeting? So pay attention to past activities. And cash flows on a monthly basis. In other words, don't budget that you're going to raise money on a monthly basis and you're going to spend it all the first month of the year. Try to project out your monthly cash flows so that you're matching the money coming in with the money going out. And I talked a little bit about updating your budget. Now, you know, if you budget that you're going to do this fundraising and you're going to raise $100,000, and then you come to the plate that you sold more tickets than you thought and say, well, okay, we're done. We got the budget. No, you can adjust budgets. A budget is a work in project. It's where you start. But that doesn't mean that you can't amend it as you go along. And then there's two concepts to financial statements that I think are important to mention. One of them is that the budget is approved by the board of directors. Approved. Now, when it comes to financial statements, You don't approve the financial statements. They are what they are. You vote to accept them. Or if somebody who's pretty knowledgeable in this stuff says, what if the board of directors doesn't approve the financial statements? Does that mean that the reporting agent, the treasurer, was lying? Or you just didn't like the results, so you're not going to approve them? No, you got to approve them. You have to accept them. Accept the financial statements as factual. This looks like it's what it is, and you can ask the questions and everything. And as the point was made, if you don't accept the financial statements, then your problem really isn't the financial statement. It's the management and the reporting. And then maybe you got to look at getting a new treasurer, or maybe you look at getting a new president of the Rotary Club if you can't accept them. But you don't approve them. You just vote to accept them. So those are some of my thoughts about financial stewardship. A key element is budgeting. And I tell you, I've been a financial advisor to for-profit organizations for, well, I'm getting pretty close to 50 years now because I'm old. And I'm amazed, I really am, at how often I come across both individuals, but organizations that don't have budgets. They just go for it. And at the end of the year, they figure out that they were successful or they weren't successful. So I think a key element of financial stewardship is that you make budgets, that you make policy through your budgets. That's what I have to say. Thanks for listening. I'm Steve Garrett.